It's not a stretch to say that New York is the center of the universe. It's been called the Big Apple, the city that never sleeps, the city of dreams, and a city so nice they named it twice.
Margarita and I are here for a little over a week, but we intend to take the biggest bite out of the Big Apple. We're crawling from downtown to uptown, and we begin in the East Village. The East Village is possibly New York's most exciting food destination, an incubator for aspiring young chefs and restaurateurs. And some of these new and inventive dining concepts really hit home. Maharlika Restaurant and Jeepney Gastropub, 5 blocks apart, both in the East Village, are two Filipino restaurants opened by Nicole and her partner, Miguel Trinidad. In Time Out New York's 2014 Battle of the Burgers, Jeepney bested dozens of contenders and emerged the winner with their original Chori Burger.
So this is achara and then lettuce, tomato on the side, the camote fries.
I'll try the camote fries.
This is our crack sauce.
Crack sauce? Is it legal?
Yes.
These are good camote fries.
Thank you. So this is a double patty here that we created, and it's half beef and it's half longanisa that we've uncased. So it's literally a double patty. And then we like to put an egg on it because why not? It's a silog and a burger.
Yes. Cheerio.
Here we go. I can taste the longanisa. Very good. I can see why you won. This is the best burger in New York City. Wow.
So good with achara.
I like how you can really taste the Pinoy in it.
That's true.
At the same time, it's so appealing. Just how popular is Filipino cuisine becoming in New York? In the East Village alone, there are 4 Filipino restaurants within walking distance of each other. There's Maharlika, Jeepney, The Ugly Kitchen, and Mama Fina's House of Filipino Sisig.
Sam Santa Maria is the son-in-law of Mama Fina, and he's the guy behind the bar at the East Village restaurant.
Wow!
And this is supposed to be a spicy sisig, right?
Well, you can see the sili.
Yes.
Okay, I'm gonna take a bite before this gets
Yeah, you go first. Well, it's hot. Really?
Crunchy.
Well, that's the way I like it.
Yum.
That's the way I like it. Sam, are you Filipino by any chance?
I am, but I was born and raised here in the U.S.
Okay.
Crunchy bits. Yum.
This is really good. That's why I love sisig. Crunchy. So these are the recipes of Delfina Dolor, better known as Mama Fina. Sam is married to the daughter of Mama Fina, Aming, whom he met in Bicol.
A short walk away from Mama Fina's is Ugly Kitchen.
Ugly Kitchen. Chef Alice Tuazon is the man behind the dream. Alice represents the best of the Filipino, motivated, creative, and passionate.
So wait a minute, you have to tell us why Ugly Kitchen?
The main reason why Ugly Kitchen is because when we opened this one, we were trying to register it, the health department at that time to open. My main idea is to name it Dirty Kitchen because Ooh. Back home, we all have Dirty Kitchen, right?
Yeah.
So we wanted to name it Dirty Kitchen, but when we're trying to register it, sabi nila, you cannot name this Dirty Kitchen because of the health code.
Really?
Yeah.
The health department
So, and then the inspector itself said, why don't you name it Ugly Kitchen? And then we came up like, you know what? Let's name it Ugly Kitchen.
Ah, you're paying him royalties?
Today, we're having a bone marrow salpicao and a good old escabeche.
Bone marrow salpicao. This is really, really good.
Yeah, the meat is really yummy. I love the parts with the fat too. Oh, your turn.
I thought you'd never let it go. I was saying, well, she's taking her time, huh?
Even your escabeche looks super. It's also nice that you don't temper the flavors for the market. Like, this garlic rice is the way we would have garlic rice in Manila. And that's how we want the foreign palate to enjoy it.
Today, we're heading to Manhattan's Lower East Side, where Katz Deli has been serving customers for over 100 years. You can't come to New York and not have a sandwich at Katz.
Jake Dell is only in his early 30s, but he's the fifth generation owner of Katz, and his mandate is to keep things the same.
That's what people expect. They want to see exactly the same, right? They want the sounds and the smells to be the same as when they were kids or the last time when they were here. And so that's very important for us to maintain that tradition and that atmosphere. So we do whatever we can to change nothing.
Katz is an old-school delicatessen that still follows the same methods of smoking, pickling, spicing, and curing that was first used when the store opened in 1888, bringing the flavors of the old world to 19th century New York.
Oh my God, it smells wonderful in here.
Okay, here we go.
So, we're having one pastrami and one corned beef.
One pastrami, one corned beef.
Oh my God.
Courage tasting here.
Always the same. Ooh, corned beef. Oh. Different, but good too.
Nice and light.
This is like a real serious New York style sandwich.
Never forget the pickle.
Of course. And the green tomatoes.
Life is a pickle, believe me.
Katz is a New York institution for a reason. They serve seriously delicious pastrami and corned beef sandwiches. Juicy and tender, great with mustard, even better with pickles and green tomatoes.
There are other items on the menu, like matzo ball soup, knobblewurst, and liverwurst. But the size of the pastrami sandwich would easily feed a city.
Hey, I see the Philippine flag. We must be at Chismis.
That's exactly what we were talking about.
We're at Chismis.
Jappy Avzilias is the chef behind Manhattan's newest Filipino restaurant, Chismis. In local dialect, Chismis translates to gossip, as in, what's the latest Chismis? And the latest Chismis is this.
Filipino food is only going one way, and that's forward, up and above.
Oh my gosh.
Enjoy both, you guys.
We've had so much food since we started the food crawl, but
I can smell.
I'm feeling little knots in my stomach because I'm excited to taste it.
Yeah. This is supposed to be a vegan pancit, and this is the version of laing from Chismis, which apparently is their best seller. It's so mahamot.
No, mahamot.
Okay, let's do this. Aligie, my favorite ingredient in the world. We're nice.
Now I can smell the aligie. Yeah.
Yeah. Mmm. Mmm. Oh, wow. Oh, my God. This aligie pasta, oh, my gosh. It's so good because it's nice angel hair. So you can really taste the crab fat. And then the crab meat is like, my God, it feels like they just steamed it like a few minutes ago.
That's your point. It's just falling apart.
Yeah. Really good.
The laing, it's very tasty. You know, I wouldn't say spice is the word. See if you agree with me.
Mmm. It's spicy, huh?
I said like that. From the Lower East Side, we crawl to Soho. Baltazar is a Soho brasserie that has enjoyed a following among fashionistas and celebrities since it opened its doors in 2007. But Margarita and I don't have a reservation. But it's past 3 p.m., so we take a chance. And voila, a table is available.
Baltazar serves French bistro classics like oysters, escargot, chicken liver, moule marinier, steak frites, and even Eggs Benedict. And, of course, we order everything.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Thank you. To the crawl.
Oysters first, right?
Oysters first.
Perfect. Thank you, dear.
There you go.
Yum, yum.
Oh my God, this is so much better than Cavite oysters.
No, they're really yummy.
It is.
I have to say. And then, of course, the iconic fries of Balthazar.
Okay, why do you call it iconic fries of Balthazar?
Because they're so known for their fries. Their fries are really good. They're skinny and they're like always like crunchy.
And then a funny thing happened.
A very New York moment.
We made
friends with the neighbors.
I'm 63 now.
What?
We don't.
See, he's older than me.
I'm only 30.
Yes, I am.
What the hell is going on?
Exactly.
No, you know what it is? We take the sun really well.
I just want to know that every time you have a food crawl, I'm always available.
This is the life, right?
Yes, it is.
Right?
Lombardi's claims to be New York's first pizzeria, opening its doors in 1905. Gennaro Lombardi, originally from Naples, is credited for developing a New York-style pizza.
Oh my God, Lombardi's.
Okay. What's the right way to eat pizza?
Fold. The Italian way. Fold and then subo. One, two.
This is good mozzarella cheese.
The crust is smoky, it's a little burnt. Then it's crusty on the outside. The mozzarella's nice. And then there's just the right amount of tomato. So it's not like smothered. Sarap. So good.